California's freeways, by agreement of Californians and out-of-staters who have had the misfortune to travel them, are the most crowded and infuriating highways in the nation. Today, California took a step to correct conditions through computers. ABC's Dick Shoemaker reports.
California's Governor Ronald Reagan pushed a button today and activated the most ambitious freeway control system anywhere in the world. Earlier, we asked the Division of Highways.
I'm Dick Murphy with the California Department of Transportation, and I'm here today to illustrate what the capabilities of the status display map for LA County, Ventura County, and Orange County are in the Central Business District. And the map was generated in the late 70s, somewhere around 1978 to 1998. They went to a projection system and a new traffic management center. We used what we call LEDs, light emitting diodes, for our light display. The capabilities of the LED is a single module with three light sources within that module we call the LED on a every 30 second basis, and with a color code we can let the operator know what are the traffic flow conditions. Again, green is speeds greater than 35 miles per hour, yellow speeds between 20 and 35, and red speeds less than 20 miles per hour. And a flashing red light would depict an abnormal traffic flow condition. Each LED is representing traffic from a set of four mainline loops. In some areas, we have as much as six or eight lanes in one direction. Yes, I believe that the LED development that was done for us at that time and the use of it in our system was the first of its kind, as far as I know, in the nation. Certainly on the West Coast. On the map, we're going to show the buildup of surveillance information coming in from the loops out in the field. From the 1978, when we installed the map, we had a relatively small amount of loops as depicted by the green lights on the map in the present time. And over the time period, it builds up, and you can see to what we have building up to a system of over 2,000 stations up till 1998, when we abandoned this board and moved on to a new location. Now, what we're not looking at, unfortunately, isn't actually traffic data, but rather a device that our electronic engineers whipped up so they could keep track of how we implemented the mapping, and also as a device to check the electronics as we implemented the system over the 20-year period. On a typical morning in the LA Basin, in the 1980s. And you can see there's a scattering of yellows and reds and greens throughout the district. This was put together with the idea that when we did get tour groups in, they didn't want to stand there for 3 hours. Rather than the 30 second, it's a snapshot every 15 minutes to give them an idea, really, of how the traffic builds up and fades away in the Los Angeles area. As the morning peak shifts over, we'll now jump to the afternoon peak. And if you notice, we went into a green display again, and it'll start to show you the afternoon buildup. And you probably notice that the buildup in the afternoon is much more abrupt. Now this will run into what we used to call the evening, when people got apparently home and the traffic eased off. You notice in the center of the map, the Central Business District is still the heaviest congestion pattern. Okay, that's the end of the tour group. Okay, this is a piece of information. The map was driven by central computers during its real life, but it's geared now so that it can run off a CRT, and all the programming is contained and done in assembly language.
Yeah. I just want to say we're using the assembly language, that's the low language, to work with the micro 6800 microprocessor in that time.
That was the state of the art at that time, and it's geared to the equipment that we'll be giving with the map entirely.
Yeah.
So all it needed is that you don't really need an outside source of data coming in. It's all contained in the three pieces of equipment we're talking about. Right?
Yeah.
the board here, and the electronics are all geared in here. On the CRT, the device that controls the map display controller is the CRT, and if you can see the screen, it's pre-programmed to do all those things that we demonstrated with the face of the map. And it's all on the chip, so it's all required. You're going to be taking this system and running it somewhere else. And the electronics are all geared in here to talk directly to the map display controller, which we'll move over to next. Now there's the CRT and this controller device cabinet here runs the entire map system. The only additional outside would, of course, be the power to run all the electronics. Okay, the plugs, it's a plug-and-play system that a plug combines a lot of the wires into a single group of wires that go back from this device under the floor and back up into the map display panels on the backside, which we'll show you next. This is the backside of the display map we showed you, and across the face of the map are six of these vertical units that contain three modules, if you were, of electronic equipment to control the LEDs on the face of the map, and all the electronics on the face of the map are geared through. These are in turn geared and controlled by the status map display controller that we showed you previously. These panels can be taken out in the face map, and the wiring to the face is actually on the panels. Power supply here, cards which have the electronics for the control of each individual LED. Say this represents one of six horizontal units with three each, so there's 18 separate units such as this in the board with the face which make the overall map.
Before they found out how good drywall is.
That's a good
stuff. Yeah.
So,
I think there is a problem with this one sitting there.
What, how was the interconnection? I mean, they all came down, they're all coming down as units.
True.
Yeah.
Yeah, we six basic units electronically, and they kept them all together. It's all the guts of the system.
Why your shirt is bolted one?
Okay. It's not every day I get to put holes in a wall.
Okay, how you want to do it?
Just put it down, turn on the cable, and then we'll...
Back it up, Trio.
Back it up.
Oh, crap.
I'm with you.
Okay.
Just another shirt.
What?
Well, no, don't feel bad. Please don't. I had a brand new pair of pants on one day. Brand new work, and ripped them just like you ripped that, and I just looked at them.
Okay. You know?
Yeah.